video on Instagram. It's been requested by not you guys, it's also been requested on YouTube. So what we're going to do is we're going to go slowly and we're going to break it down. The purpose in the dojo, the mats are perfect because we've got literally a nice crisscross line. So as the James comes to a line, I come to a line. So what we're doing, we're actually standing hip width either side of a line. It's very difficult to see that line on the video. We've got it all the way down and we've got the side lines as well. Okay. And there's two ways of doing this. One main thing is that you've got to keep your hands still. The Sukhu footman's hands must be still. If you're not wearing a gi or not wearing a belt, your hands should just be placed on your legs. You should put your hands down slightly, which makes you bend your knees just slightly forward. That keeps you very, very earthy. It's very, very easy when you start doing this at golf. That tangent for bringing your feet up because it's actually quite light. As you start to move faster, you start to bring your feet in. If you actually bend your knees slightly, your feet stay hip width apart, yeah? With your knees bent, it puts the brake on as you step. Now with this, you always move off on the left-hand side. There's three parts to this. So, the first one is forward motion. This is called neutral. Okay, so from here, I'll say to Jimmy to begin. Sensei James and I will move forward. You move forward on your left foot, and your right foot comes up hip width behind it. And Jimmy, itch. Now if you notice, feet are hip width either side of the line, they're also hip width at the angle. So I've got very, very good balance. I'm centered. I'm not in deep stance. If Sensei goes in deep stance, he's strong in two directions only at that very, very moment. Alright, he has attacked and he's now just centered himself with a deep stance. He's very, very strong forward and very, very quickly. If someone's in the back and pushes, he's very, very strong backward. He's incredibly weak there. There's eight directions of balance breaking, main directions. If you stand as a sitting top, with your legs together, right? There's forwards, backwards, left, right, and then there's the four corners. So these are your main eight. I like to call it our Union Jack, our Union Flag. It's the easiest way to remember it. Put your Union Flag, you've got your England Flag, and then your Scotland Flag. Forgive me if I leave out the Irish bit. Okay, so you've got eight directions, your balance can be broken. So if you go into a deep stance sideways, like, oh my god, I lost the horse, then you're obviously very, very strong at that moment there, very, very strong there, but you're incredibly weak there, so you push your arm back there, and again, the angles. You're only strong in two points, in two directions at any one time. 6 weeks. Okay, so Sensei James goes into a hip-width stance, forward. Obviously, at this particular moment, he's strong forward and backwards. Because his stance is so narrow, and he's centered, if I go and push him sideways, he can very, very quickly step back into neutral and make himself strong. If I go to push him forwards, he can go and stance forward. Make yourself strong. So basically, you can move very, very quickly. And that's the idea of being keeping hip width. Okay, so what we're going to do, we're going to run through the first set. We're only going to do a count of four. Traditionally, you do a count of eight. Okay, so your hands are either on your knees, tucked in your belt, you've got a belt, keep your elbows in, stop your hands flapping about. We're going to go forwards first. Do it. Itch. Second one, we come back over the line. Knee. So what you'll find is one's back, one's forward, and you're still hip width. You now come back, stand, and then you come back to neutral, shin. You now lean onto the right hand side. Go, rock, stitch, patch, neutral. Generally speaking, traditionally, you do another count the same. Count of eight. Okay? Right, what we do, we'll just run through this once, silently. Some styles, when they move forward, they turn their feet out, or the back leg out, for stability. Fine, I'm not going to knock it, I'm not saying it's wrong. It's in the style, it's in the style. Because we use a lot of kicks, and we're actually a counter-attack. I move forward, if he's standing down on that, and I move forward to attack, and I put sideways, I'm now actually thinking, this range, I can't punch him, but he's actually in kicking range. But with my foot turned sideways, I'm kicking there. Yeah? Where you aim the foot is where it goes. So if you're here, and you step that forward, then it comes forward. Think of it, in the wrong term, as a gun. If you bring the gun up to there, and shoot, it shoots him in the foot. You aim it, you fire it. If you bring it up to there, and you fire it, it's in the face. So wherever the foot's aiming. So when we move, we keep the feet facing the front.